Vice Mayor.
Okay, come on over.
Good morning. Last Tuesday, the Cincinnati Health Department informed City Manager's Office that Cincinnati had its first two confirmed cases of monkeypox, a viral disease that has been spreading in the United States since May. In response to the presence of monkeypox cases here, we as a city have begun a close partnership with the county and local health experts to proactively take steps to stop the spread of this virus. Today, I'm joined by Hamilton County Commissioner Denise Driehaus, Councilmember Reggie Harris, Vice Mayor Jan Michelle Lemming Kearney, Cincinnati Interim Health Commissioner Grant Musman, Hamilton County Health Commissioner Greg Kesterman, Dr. Jennifer Forrester of UC Health, and Tiffany Mattingly of the Health Collaborative. These regional leaders and experts will discuss the information we have, expectations moving forward, and recommendations to help all residents stay as safe as possible. As the past couple of years have shown us, it is absolutely critical during public health challenges to listen to the experts and to make data-driven, informed decisions to keep our friends, neighbors, and relatives safe. The City of Cincinnati and Hamilton County remain committed to this, and in collaboration with the broader health community, we will continue to do what we can to keep our communities informed and safe. It's important to note that since the beginning of this monkeypox issue, Councilmember Reggie Harris has been on the ground working collaboratively with the county, with the city, to bring us all together to make this very important announcement around the prevention of monkeypox and the awareness in our community. Up next is Hamilton Commissioner Denise Driehaus.
Thank you. I'm going to just speak very briefly because I, like you, want to hear from the experts related to what's going on with monkeypox. But I do want to say, and as the mayor alluded to, Reggie Harris, council member, called the other day and said, hey, what are we doing about monkeypox? You know, we've got a couple of cases here in Cincinnati. People are asking questions. They want to know what the disease is, how the disease is spread, and what we can do about it locally to try to prevent monkeypox from becoming a large issue here in Cincinnati and in Hamilton County. And I will tell you from firsthand experience, my son lives in New York, and they are standing in very long lines trying to get the monkeypox vaccine in New York City. And so, you know, we brought folks together, and Reggie was really the tip of the spear here. But we already have an infrastructure that we have used because of COVID-19. Before that, we did not have this kind of automatic collaboration, but we have a system now that we can stand up because we've been through this before. This is like drill number two. And so the county and the city and the city health department and the county health department and the health collaborative and the hospitals all now know how to work together with one another to make sure this community is informed and we're providing accurate information so that people can remain safe. And so I'm really proud of the infrastructure that's been built. It's been a couple of years in the making, but here we are. And this, Reggie, I think you brought it to my attention last week. The mayor got involved, and here we are with relative partners to make sure that people have the information they need. So with that, I'm going to introduce Councilmember Reggie Harris.
Thank you, Mayor Pirovall and Commissioner Driehaus. I appreciate your words and praise, but I have to say, though I may have been the tip of the spear, the response by our city health officials, our city administration, the mayor and the county commission was swift and fast, and we are all lockstep and moving forward. So as a member of the LGBTQI plus community, I feel this deeply because many folks in my community are afraid of contracting the monkeypox virus, have maybe even contracted it, and we feel little echoes of a time before when we think about other illnesses that may had a more specific population that it was targeted. And so we know coming out of COVID-19, as the commissioner said, we have a robust and strong infrastructure to be very proactive. And I believe the leadership in this city, we can really lead in the nation in being responsive to the monkeypox virus. I appreciate the effort that is being taken by the CDC and local health departments to destigmatize the monkeypox virus and ensure that discrimination isn't endured by those that may have it. However, I do want to make sure that we are very clear in our messaging, and that although anyone can contract monkeypox virus, most cases are among men who have sex with men, which is why we must target our education and our messaging to those individuals in the community, the LGBTQI plus community. It's a delicate situation, and it must be handled with care, while also, again, providing very clear and direct messaging, which I'm so excited to have our experts here to be able to answer any questions. And then I just want to close by saying over the next few weeks, I will work closely with our city and county administrators, our health experts, both public and private, on an advocacy plan to take more proactive steps in providing the monkeypox vaccine. So with that, I will bring up Dr. Grant Musman.
Thank you. So I'm Grant Musman. I'm the interim health commissioner for the city of Cincinnati. And Greg Kesterman is here with me too. He is the health commissioner for Hamilton County. I just want to emphasize that monkeypox does require a public health response that works very closely with providers for the healthcare delivery response and for evaluation of folks who may be at risk of having it or have the symptoms. And the City of Cincinnati Health Department's been working closely with the Hamilton County Health Department to figure out exactly how those components fit together and what the public health response looks like.
Good morning, Greg Kesterman, Health Commissioner for Hamilton County. And very much like the beginning of COVID, you know, we started working and collaborating together. I do really want to start off by making sure to reiterate that what we've already heard is that right now in Ohio, we are not seeing a lot of cases. In fact, we only have 23 cases in the state of Ohio, two here in Hamilton County so far. So we are not seeing the spread that we are seeing in other communities, but now is the time to do that kind of groundbreaking work and get things together. The public health response will continue just like COVID with a lot of information, making sure the public has access to information, making sure that we're working with our partners to help clear the vaccine. There's a process to getting vaccine to our healthcare providers, and then managing vaccination for un- and under-vaccinated or underinsured Medicaid patients. And then lastly, just like COVID-19, our team is responsible for contact tracing, which we have a lot of experience with. As Commissioner Driehaus said, we really built this system already during COVID-19, and we're going to continue to leverage the system that we have built to manage any cases of monkeypox that we see within our community. Information can be found on our webpage, which is hcph.org/monkeypox. Here you'll find information about who is eligible for the vaccine, more information about the virus, and information from the Centers for Disease Control. It's important to remember that monkeypox is a rare disease, and it's usually not seen in the United States, so this is kind of a new occurrence in our country. However, we are seeing cases increase. Monkeypox is spread through close, intimate skin-to-skin contact with someone who has monkeypox, so the chances of you just going into the community today and getting monkeypox remain extremely low. It's important to work closely with your healthcare provider if you feel you have symptoms or may have been exposed to an active case. As already mentioned, public health will work with that healthcare provider to make sure that we are getting information, and if a vaccine is needed because of exposure, we are able to get that vaccine back to the healthcare provider to provide to the patient. And with that, I will turn it over to Dr. Forrester.
Actually, Greg, if I can just add too that we have that for City of Cincinnati residents, we have that information on the City of Cincinnati Health Department website as well.
Hello, I am Jen Wall Forrester. I'm an infectious diseases specialist at UC Health. Was stated, monkeypox coming out of a pandemic where we had a very infectious respiratory spread disease, monkeypox is a little different. As mentioned, it's a close contact. Actual skin to skin or with body fluids, and certainly not as, we do not believe as respiratory droplets as much transmission in that respect. So definitely looking at, as Councilman Harris mentioned, that we want to target. Currently, what we're seeing in the United States is that the population most affected right now is men who have sex with men. But that may or may not be the case. This, although certainly sexual contact is a close intimate contact, it is not the only way that this virus is spread. So just to be clear on how the virus is spread, typically this comes up as usually most patients have a prodrome beforehand. So this is where people feel kind of cruddy. They feel like they have the flu, they have a headache, they might have a fever, they might have body aches. And then typically that's followed by a rash a couple of days later. The rash is, as the name would describe, poxy, which usually means like a little bubble, but it can be present in a lot of different ways. Some people actually don't have that prodrome at all and may only develop the rash, so it may be different from patient to patient, and that's why it's important to, if you even suspect that you had a contact or suspect that your rash may be related to monkeypox, that you see your healthcare provider and get tested. And then as we've discussed, there's a robust public health system behind that to do contact tracing and then vaccinate anyone who is exposed. And with that, I will turn it over as well to see if there's any other.
Is Tiffany here? Mm-hmm. No? Dr. Forster, if you guys don't mind, I have a couple of questions. First off, can you define what proderm is?
Yes.
And second of all, other than sex, what else constitutes a physical touch that would pass the virus?
Right. Yes, sorry about that, using medical terminology. But so a prodrome is just that kind of feeling you feel before you know you're really sick, right? So it's just, I don't feel good. I don't feel normal today. So that's mostly what that is, the time right before your fever or your rash or something like that. And so, again, in the United States, there are people who have monkeypox who are not MSM. Like we said, that's the majority of people, but other people have it as well. And so kissing can be a close intimate contact. Rubbing against any sores or open lesions or even potentially some certain types of scabs can be contact. That's direct skin-to-skin contact and can transfer the virus from one person to another. Again, anything we can do preventative to stop more cases in our community that can then stop those cases from reaching all parts of our community.
Dr. Forster, can we all ask real quickly? We're wearing masks again. This is because of COVID. This is gonna be so confusing for so many people. That's why messaging, we all know, is very important.
Yep.
Masks for COVID, but that's not because of monkeypox necessarily, right?
Correct, right. There is potentially, just as a scientific aside, there is potentially droplet spread with monkeypox, but that is not well studied and not what we think is the main way it is the main way that COVID gets from person to person, not the main way that monkeypox gets from person to person.
So, I mean, during the AIDS epidemic, safe sex came out of that, condom use, all of that. Are you now recommending that same kind of protocol to help prevent the spread of this?
So I recommend safe sex for a lot of reasons, for the spread of a lot of other diseases. But as I mentioned, and condom use can help, but it is not the only way that should be used to prevent the spread. So it is really just skin-to-skin contact, not necessarily body fluids, which is what condoms may help protect against.
I also thank you for that question. I also want to be very clear. What's important about this is awareness of one's body, right? Recognizing and being in touch, looking for symptoms and skin, and then isolating and being proactive about seeking treatment. So that we understand that this is absolutely something that we have control over, because we can make very clear short-term decisions about our body and our contact with people. So again, in messaging, it is about being aware of that proderm feeling that was described very clearly. It's about checking out your body, seeing any unusual rashes or lesions, and then connecting with your primary care provider. Very simple, easy steps that anyone can follow to be able to mitigate the impacts of this virus.
One more question that I have, sorry guys. What are the health outcomes of monkeypox other than the rash or the pox themselves?
Right. So to date, there have not been many deaths, so it's not a particularly serious disease for most people. Like we saw with COVID, I believe I heard on the radio today that there was a death reported in a different part of the country or a different part of the world that was outside of Africa, where they don't have as many, not as much access to good medical care, but in a place that actually did have access to medical care. Typically, that is going to be in immunosuppressed populations, just like with COVID. But the rash can be pretty extensive, actually, and can be disturbing for people, as you can imagine. Luckily, this country, we haven't seen smallpox in the past because of great vaccination efforts several decades ago. And we also haven't seen a whole lot of chickenpox these days. I mean, I had chickenpox, but many of our younger communities have not. So the rash can be pretty distinctly affecting people and can potentially leave scars.
You mentioned vaccine, and this might be for anybody out there that can answer this question. Should people start thinking about getting a vaccine, and what is the availability of the vaccine, and how effective is it in holding that off and holding off this disease?
Right. So I'll talk quickly about the effectiveness of the vaccine, and then I'll let others kind of talk about the availability. But if given within about 4 days of a contact, the efficacy of preventing the signs of monkeypox is about 85%. Given within 4 to 14 days, that comes down a little bit, but still pretty high. And again, I will again echo Councilman Harris's comment that it's really about watching your body, knowing your symptoms, because even during that time, if you would develop symptoms, you'd want to isolate and prevent transmission to others.
So you're not necessarily recommending everybody just run out who might be at risk and getting the vaccine right now as a preventative measure, like we did with COVID?
Well, I will again turn it over for availability of vaccine, but at this point, you know, there's a trickle-down effect from public health officials as to how much we actually have available.
Not much. the vaccine supply at this time is extremely limited and is being portioned to the states by the CDC based on a risk calculation. The strategy with vaccination right now is to get vaccine into the arms of folks who are recently exposed or who are early in their symptom course. And the rationale there is, even if you're early in the symptom course and you have monkeypox, you can actually decrease the duration of having the active lesions and decrease the likelihood, which will decrease the likelihood of spreading. And then, of course, vaccinating the people who've been exposed, if you can vaccinate them early, you can again decrease the likelihood of spreading. Hopefully in the future there will be more vaccine available, but right now that's the strategy and the rationale. For the providers out there, for folks who are seeing patients who may have been exposed to monkeypox or definitely have been, so the way the vaccine allocation works, we can get you the vaccine. But you just need to call us and we'll share the contact information.
Dr. Mussman, I'm curious, what lessons are we learning right now from San Francisco and New York and the density of, do you think it's a situation that people just have not been aware as we're trying to make Cincinnatians aware, or what's your impression?
So I think we have a new disease that's spreading in a different manner, but in ways that we've seen before, not just with COVID, but I think someone referenced the early AIDS epidemic. And, you know, we have different stigmas and different hesitations to get through in terms of contact tracing or, you know, identifying risk exposures. So I think there's lots of lessons to be learned from all of those things. The symptoms can be a bit nonspecific. You know, you get that I feel bad prodrome, and then you get the rash, which is why it's important to have the provider involved, and also to make sure that there aren't other diseases that need to be tested for or evaluated for.
And I'll have a really quick follow-up maybe to you, Dr. Forrester. you know, it's not just men with men. It's also we're learning that it could be linens and it could be things that are touched. And at what point, I mean, is there some concern that folks who aren't in that category would be like, I don't want to hug my kid if I'm at a swim meet or whatever? I mean, how does that go?
Right. So this is the delicate line that Councilman Harris kind of talked about, right? So, again, stated, anyone can get this disease. But getting information out to those most affected right now is very important. And yes, there have been cases, or at least the thought that is how that would spread in some of the other communities. You mentioned what are we learning from other places where this is spreading, and we're learning those things. So making sure that linens and towels, et cetera, are cared for appropriately if you are someone that develops a rash, really. So it's really from the lesions, though, right? So it's not just I'm not gonna shake hands or whatever, but the other thing that we hope we've learned through COVID and ways that everyone can protect themselves, I'll say it again, is wash your hands too. That's one of the ways that we can protect everyone.
Can I just add one?
Yes.
And I do want to add again, because this is an information campaign. This is not to cite any sort of hysteria. We have the tools as a community to manage this, right? We look after each other, we recognize our body symptoms, and then we respond appropriately. And all we're saying is that this is a moment where we need to put that at the forefront, right? We remember when we had chicken pox, and you would look at your children and you'd say, oh, that looks strange. Let me check this out. And you would take precautions. It's the same thing, except it's a little bit more targeted, and has a little bit more of an acute reaction. So I do want to make sure that as we are talking about this messaging, this is something that we absolutely have the power to help mitigate and to take proactive steps with. And it's just simply about awareness, reporting, engaging with your provider.
Councilman, you real quick.
I just want to follow up just real quick. So it's, and Reggie just said it, this, when people develop these symptoms, they should contact their primary care provider. The health departments, the city and the county are partnering with the private sector, with the hospital sector, to make sure that we have vaccine when necessary. But the point of contact for the individual is their primary care provider. So that's where they should go if they develop symptoms or suspect that they may have been exposed.
I was just gonna ask quickly, Councilman Harris, within the LGBTQ plus community, for those that are not connected to that in certain ways, is there, you're saying we're not here to incite any panic or whatnot, is there some anxiety? What's the message in that community?
So the message is actually very clear, and it's, and again, when I said in my remarks about a plan to advocate towards the CDC, it's just to make sure that we are working as diligently as possible, one, to produce more of the vaccine, and two, to have more distributed and available to states. We know across the United States that there are issues with supply chain across all sectors, but to elevate this and to move with a sense of urgency. So that's the sense of urgency, is about making sure that we have enough vaccine and that the current process by which our public health departments can receive the vaccine is truncated some, right? So that it doesn't have so many steps, but it's just available more widespread.
And real quick, just because I like to ask questions, last to you, Dr. Forrester, one more. We have two cases in Cincinnati now, going 23 in Ohio, as Greg said. At what point do the alarm bells really start to sound if that needs to happen?
Well, I think it is the process, the step-by-step process that Councilman Harris talked about is really getting awareness out there. Hopefully that is one step to prevent further transmission. I think everyone here would say we look at anyone who is positive as something we need to start directing our messages or changing messages or expanding messages at every case we see that's positive.
Is there a specific quarantine protocol, is it more a case by case with the physicians?
Right. So there's two parts of it. Just to be clear, you know, this is one of those things we learned through COVID. Isolation is the, you know, isolating yourself when you actually have symptoms of the disease. And the person who has rash or a rash confirmed to be monkeypox, actually it can be very variable as to how long they kind of remain in isolation. It's when those lesions have not only scabbed over, but also have new skin formation over them so that they're not open, and that's every lesion. Also, we would hope that they didn't, by that time, didn't have a fever. And that can vary from person to person based on their, you know, how well their skin heals. In terms of quarantine, which is the exposed individual, this is one of those times where we ask people to really watch your body, know your body, and know the symptoms that are coming up, right? So it's a good, most symptoms will show up between 1 to 2 weeks after exposure, but it can be as long as 21 days or even a bit longer of time to really watch yourself, know what your symptoms are, do skin exams on yourself, look for the prodrome, that kind of thing. And to look at your risk factors and try to maybe pull those back if you weren't going to be in a sporting event or any other issue. So again, watch your body. This is knowledge for you, and to really pay attention to yourself and your own symptoms and your own activities.
Mayor Pirovall, real quick to you, I mean, maybe a closing remark. I mean, we're all so tired of everything right now. It's like, are you kidding me? But such a serious issue. I mean, the fatigue factor, you're the mayor of a big city. How do you encourage people to buckle down?
Well, look, what makes Cincinnati special is that we look after each other. And this is another opportunity for us to take personal responsibility, to do everything that we need to do to keep ourselves safe, and as a result, keep our family and our community safe. I'll just end by saying this. We continue to be in the original pandemic of COVID-19, and we have been seeing numbers steadily increase. The city is recommending mask wearing, and just want to reiterate that in order to protect yourself and your community, getting vaccinated, getting boosted, wearing masks indoors if you can't socially distance, because while we have very good hospital capacity at this point, as we've seen in the past, particularly with Omicron, that can change very quickly. So as Councilmember Harris has said, we have the capacity to deal with monkeypox, we have the capacity to deal with COVID-19. We just have to be aware, take personal responsibility, and take action in order to keep us all safe. Thank you all so much.
Thank you.